Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. It's Francesco again. Here on Keep Productive today, we're going to be doing a first impressions on the brand new Kanban feature inside of the desktop experience on TickTick. Now, for those who don't know, TickTick is a to-do list application. If you're a user already, this experience is about to get enhanced and I'm going to overview the feature, how it's going to be used and also a bit more about it. So you get a good idea of what you'll be getting inside of the new Kanban board. So without further ado, let's jump in. Okie dokie, so I'm downloading this version of it. It's a DMG version, so it might take a few moments to load up. Okie dokie, so as you can imagine, it will be available through the next update on desktop. So if you're looking at Windows and Mac editions, then there will be a specific update. You won't have to go through this lengthy process. I was sent over a beta edition. And do note that if there's any issues with this, I'm sure they'll iron it out. This beta was sent to me about 3 or 4 days ago, just to be clear. So obviously the way that you access this is, for example, if you're on today, you can go down to one of your projects or lists, they call them inside of TickTick. And as you can see, it still remains the same. Of course, you can go and use this as normal, but what you can do, and let's just choose a project, the creating for work. And what you can do is go to these three buttons here and select the Kanban view. Now, I actually first saw this when Rebecca Ford posted it, and I did see a few times that they teased this experience in terms of being able to use a Kanban as a way to organize. So you can see here that you can start creating your own columns. And as you can see here, most of them are in to-do, and that's mainly because they have no status or column already associated to it. So if I click in, of course, it pops out like this. I quite like this automatically because I can edit all of the relevant details like due date. I can tick it off. I can add a priority level up here, add a description, and even move to a certain project without necessarily digging deeper. Now, if I want to, I could drag between the statuses. It is that easy. And just above it, in each of the new areas, I can begin to add a new task. So let's start adding a new task. Let's say edit Kanban review. I can go ahead and add a due date to this, as well as obviously a duration. I believe that's locked under premium, but if you're a premium user, you will get access to that. I can go ahead and add a priority as well. And once I press enter, it will get created as this card view. Now, if I double tap, I won't actually go into a separate view. I'm guessing they'll probably be adding this in the future. I only get this view here. And if I want to, I can go over to the calendar view and still view it in the same format. Now, for example, here you can see the same feature. And as you can imagine, in the calendar view, it's very similar to what the Kanban view shows. Now, if I go back over to the project, it's still inside of this Kanban view. Now, one of the many benefits is I can create new columns if I want. So, for example, if I want to create a column called Done, I can go ahead and click OK and drag another into here. Now, if I go ahead and tick them off, I can actually have a completed section. So done as a column might become irrelevant to you. So for example, if you're organizing this in, for example, to do, progress, and done, you don't necessarily have that done section. But if you're managing it by maybe project or who's it's assigned to, then this can be very different. Now let's look at the settings over in the right-hand corner. So we've got the ability to customize, obviously, our layout of the Kanban, but you can do it based on time. So for example, it will shortlist inside of that. For example, here you can see overdue becomes a separate column, and you can also see next 7 days appears here. So it almost breaks it down based on time. You can also break it down based on title. So obviously the ABC and how it appears in order. And of course, based on tag too. So you can go a little bit deeper than initially predicted. So if you wanted to, here's the final edition. If you wanted to organize stuff in a column based on priority in that still status or column, then you can do. For example, here, you can have medium priority. Let's just demonstrate this. So for example, if I change this to high, and I drag this over to here, you can still see it breaks it down in a really neat fashion. So this is the Kanban board, and it is available from today for desktop versions. I'm not too sure how it's going to roll out. I'll include as much information as I know. I will provide all the details below so that you can find out how this works in detail. Now, the good final thing that you need to know is if you want to go back to that list view, you can go ahead and press list view. And of course, everything remains the same. So if I, for example, go into here, nothing has necessarily been added. And the good thing is, if I went back over to the Kanban view, everything would remain the same. So that's one of the many benefits of switching between both of these experiences. Now, just to be clear, Todoist have a feature like this rolling out soon, but they might have a slightly different take on it. But this is a good progressive move by TickTick. They're adding more and more features as they go. The one thing I'd probably like to see is actually the ability to have it available on all devices at the same time, but I know TickTick tend to release separately on different devices. So this is something just to check out, to explore, and I will include all of the relevant blog post update information that you need to know. Anyway guys, a big thank you for stopping by. If you're brand new to the Keep Productive YouTube channel, hit the subscription button. If you enjoyed this video, like the video, and if you are interested as well, you can become an email newsletter subscriber. We post out a monthly newsletter all about the latest roundups in the productivity software space so that you can strengthen your knowledge about new tools and resources. So guys, a big thank you. I will see you guys in another video. Cheers guys.